So it's not easy to go, well, it's this corrupt Mexican government, and that's why everyone's on the take. No, it's really just greed out of control. And you can't just fix it by saying, we need like a car czar, or we need a... No, you'd actually have to get rid of the SEC and go, we're going to have a panel of people that do the job of the SEC, but it can't be the SEC, or else you'd have to fire everybody at the SEC and hire new people, because those people are corrupt. And you'd have to not let them be lobbyists, ever. Like, they would have to, if you work at the SEC, you can never work in a financial institution afterwards. So you'd be getting people that are, you know, either like professors, things like that, or just are you know, not interested in working as a lobbyist or whatever, but that have the expertise. I would tap professors, quite frankly, and retired professors, you know, people who are just have no interest in so that, you know, they can help them, like, lobby and stuff. And so, so it's almost like if you want to get a job with these companies, the quickest way is to get a job with the SEC, because half of them end up working as lobbyists when they get out. And I'm thinking, this is really corrupt, because that guy, that Madoff guy, who had that big Ponzi scheme, that went on for years. For years. And people would not invest in the company because they thought it was dirty. And the rumors that it was like a dirty company were going on for a really long time. And the SEC never questioned them.
Yeah, for the disaster. You should be taking credit for the disaster. He should go, I'm certainly not the only one to blame, but as the president, I'm definitely to blame. If there's anyone else to blame, they can line up behind me, because I'm first and foremost to blame, because I didn't see a problem here, even though I've been elected to see a problem. Unbelievable, you know. And the only reason McCain didn't get elected, why? Because he was like, everything's great. That's why he didn't get elected. You know? It's disgusting. Unbelievable. I don't know. Things are messed up. But anyway. Yeah, New York Times. Pretty cool. No, not that anyone reads it anymore. But his inaction is blameworthy. Right? I mean, there's definitely more people culpable, but he definitely was. And he, you know, in hindsight, we blame him, but Bush is disgusting. Completely incompetent, you know what I mean? Anyway. Yeah, but they'll suffer longer if they don't. Because this could go on for a decade if they just keep fighting it.
Yeah.
I mean, what started the whole problem needs to be fixed, and until that's fixed, the problem's not going to go away. And, you know, the prices will eventually have to come down, and the longer they postpone it, I think the worse it's going to be for everybody. But they will come down naturally. Not naturally, but, you know. Because you're not going to be able to sell your house at an inflated price. The only time you're going to actually be able to sell your home is when those prices stabilize and come back down. So they'll eventually do that, but I think the longer they postpone it. Because all these guys that are getting caught for these Ponzi schemes, and, you know, it's like, how much of the money that's generated in Wall Street is actually just fake? You know, that it doesn't even exist. People just think that they have all this money, and then all of a sudden they turn around and go, oh, that company invested isn't real. Oops. There goes all the money. It's fake. All that, like, fake wealth. There was some synagogue that had like several billion dollars invested in this in the company. That wasn't real. And then you think, how does a synagogue get billions of dollars? What were they up to? What's disturbing is that the financial institutions aren't releasing any of the money, and then the car companies that actually produce something can't get any money. They're the ones that actually produce things. And it isn't just them. It's all of the parts companies, everyone they do business with, that actually produce materials, who, by the way, are owed billions of dollars by the big three. It's all of those people. It's a million people, thereabouts. A million jobs involved in this. And they can't come up with, you know, 30 billion. They go on and on about car czars. And yet we gave the banks nearly a trillion. No questions asked. Like $700 million, or I'm sorry, $700 billion. So that they could keep, like, you know, loaning money and stuff so that the financial system wouldn't freeze. And they give them all this money, no strings attached, and the banks aren't loaning money. That's why we're sinking. And then they can't get a bill together to give the car industry $30 billion. To the point where Bush has to go, we're going to use some of the money, the original $700, to give them to them, because Congress can't come up with a bill that says, just give them some money so that we don't lose a million jobs in the midst of a depression. Think about that. It's disgusting that people would actually think that this was a good idea. And then they're fighting like crazy to keep the housing market from hitting rock bottom. You know? Wow, let's help people with their mortgages. That only keeps the problem going. See? You have to let it hit rock bottom because those prices are still too high. They're still inflated. They have to come back to the way they were. And until that happens, the economy's not going to stabilize. You know, there's no reason somebody's house, you know, or housing prices should be that high.